A very good day to all of you. As you all know, on the first day of each week, you learn something new. And on the next day, you all practice the same. So, in today's class, you will all revise what we have learned in the earlier class. So, let us start revising the previous class. Can you tell what is the difference between lowercase and uppercase? Using uppercase, you can change the entire line or paragraph's letters to capitals. Similarly, using the lowercase, you can change the entire line or paragraph to small letters. Can you tell what happens with capitalize every word? With capitalize every word, you can change the first letter of a word to capital. Can you tell what is a table and why do we use it? A table is formed by columns and rows being put together. This will appear like your maths notebook and it has many boxes. We use tables for many things like making a list, for office work, for making report cards, making calendars, recording students' marks or their other details, etc. Can you tell what happens with merge cell? Merge means to unite or make as one. Merge cell is used to merge two or more cells into one. Can you tell what happens with split cell? Split means to break apart or make many pieces from one. Using split cell, you can break apart one cell into more than one cell. If you want, you can split the cell horizontally or vertically. Now, all of you switch on your computer and open your writer file. In case you are having a problem in opening the writer file, watch the video and learn from it. You can open the writer file in many ways. Today you will learn a new method of opening the writer document. So first of all, you need to keep your left hand one finger on the Windows key and press the R button. A box opens, which is the run window. In this, you have to, without giving any spaces, type out SWRITER. SWRITER. And then take the cursor or the pointer to the OK button and click on OK. Your writer document will open. Next, all of you make a table containing 5 rows and 5 columns and add a student's record to it. If you face problems, watch the video and learn from it. With the help of this video, we will practice creating a table on our writer page. So to create a table, you should see your cursor on the page where you want to insert the table. Then take your pointer to the table option of the menu bar, select insert, and then select table from the options. A box opens, and in this box, it gives you options for the size. So you have to decide how many columns you want and how many rows you want. So let's say if you want 5 rows and 5 columns, use the up arrow keys to make it 5 and then click on OK. Your table will appear on your writer page. Now let's start typing the titles of our table. So in the first top cell, we are giving a title of name. Next, we use the right arrow key to come to the next cell and type the title roll number. And in the next cells on the right side, we will type the subjects, the names of the subjects. So let's type here maths. Then use the right arrow key to go to the next cell on the right side. Type English. These are titles. And then in the last column, first row, type the title Hindi. Now you can bring your cursor to the first cell below the name cell by clicking on the right arrow, or you can use your mouse and touchpad and bring the pointer to the cell where you want to write the first name of the first student. Click there. And then you can type the name as is being shown in the video to you. We type Vikas. Then click on the right arrow to go to the next cell to type the roll number for this first student. Let's type 1 as the roll number. Then go use the right arrow key, type in the maths marks, right arrow key again and type in the English marks, and so on, type in the Hindi marks. Now again, you can either use the right arrow key or use the pointer and click in the next cell where you have to type the next name of Samir, the student Samir. Come to the next cell under roll number column, type his roll number, and like this, key in the maths marks, the English marks, and the Hindi marks by keeping on using the right arrow to go to the next cell. Come to the cell below Samir and type in the next name as is being shown in the video. Rohan. Come to the roll number column, type the roll number 3, and then let's type in the marks by clicking on the right arrow to come to the next cell. Maths marks, English marks, Hindi marks. Then again use the pointer to come to the cell, last cell in the names column, and type in the name Prakash. Let's give him roll number 4 and give the maths marks, English marks and Hindi marks. So this way you will be able to create a table in your writer page and key in the data. Now all of you go ahead and show that you can insert a new row on top of the very first row. If you have a doubt, watch the video and learn from it. This video will help us practice how we can insert a row, new row, in our table. So to insert the row, we must first make sure that the cursor is positioned in one of the rows before or after which we want to insert a new row. So since we want to insert a new row before the first row, we place our cursor, we bring our pointer to the first cell of the first row. Click there and then bring your pointer to the table option of the menu bar. Click on insert and then choose rows, because we want to insert rows. Once you click on the rows option, a box opens which shows you the option of how many rows you want to insert and also gives you the option of the position. Where do you want to insert the row, before or after the cursor? So since we want to insert just one row, we will click on one, we will let it be one, and then we will click on before and click OK. So this is how we insert a row. Next, all of you merge this first row and type in your school's name in it. If you face a problem, learn more by watching the video. With the help of this video, let us now practice how we can merge the row or the cells of the row into one cell. So, to merge, your cursor should be on the row or in the row that you want to merge. So, as is being shown in the video to you, we will place our cursor in the first row which we need to merge. Click there and then take the pointer to the table option of the menu bar. Click on select. And from the options shown, click on the rows so that the row gets selected. Once this is done, now you need to merge this. So again, bring your pointer to the tables option of the menu bar. Click there and then you can click on the merge cells option. You will see that your first row, all the cells get merged into one cell. Now you need to type your school's name in this merged cell. So you can take your cursor to the middle of the merged cell by either using the space bar or by clicking on the tab key on the keyboard. So by clicking on the tab key, you can bring your cursor in the middle and then type your school name. As is being shown in the video, we are typing Computer Shiksha. So this is how you can merge the rows. Now show how you will split the very last column vertically into two parts. Then in these boxes, type in the total number and then type in one box the number that is the result. Again, if you have a problem, watch the video and learn from it. This video helps us to understand how we can use the split cell option on our table. So, in order to split a cell, first of all, we must make sure that our cursor is in that cell. So ensure that you are keeping the cursor there as is being shown in the video. And then take your pointer to the table option of the menu bar. Once you take your pointer to the table option, click on that with the left button of your mouse or touchpad and the box opens, from which you will need to select the split cells option. Another box will open which shows the number of cells or into how many parts you want to split the cell. So since we want to split the cell into two parts, we will let this be two. Otherwise, if we want more, we can click on the up arrow. If we want less, we click on the down arrow. The other option that it shows is which direction you want to split it. Since we want to split horizontally, we will click vertically. Since we want to split vertically, we will click on vertical and then click on OK. So you will see that the cell there where your cursor was has got split into two parts. Now you can use the second part of the cell to do something new. For instance, if you want to add all the marks of the student, you can total them up and then you can put the total marks in the new cell which has been formed by split cell. So this is how you will use split cell on your table on the writer page. Now show how you will change the design of your table. In case of a problem, watch the video and learn from it. In this video, let us learn how we can apply auto format to our table. Since auto format gives us many options, pre-existing options, it is easy. First, let the cursor be in the table. Then, take the pointer to the table option in the menu bar, click on that, and then click on the auto format option. You will see a box opens, and in this there are many formats, so you can scroll up or down and select the one which you like. You can click on these options and see how the table would appear if you use this, and then you can click on the one which you like, and then we will be pressing the OK button. So once that is done, the format that you have selected gets applied to the table as is being shown in the video. So this is how you will use auto format for your tables. We will now end today's class here. Show that you can save the writer file at a new place. Shut down your computer using the proper process. In today's class, you practiced the use of change case and the options of the table menu, like inserting a table, merge cell, split cell, and auto format. Thank you.